Namaham Vishnupadaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharane Nirvisesha Shunyavari Paschacha Desa Tarane. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Sankirtan Movement Ki Jai, Transcendental Book Distribution Ki Jai. I just make a short class trying to, again, hopefully able to inspire someone to distribute books and give me some blessings. First, to just continue, I don't have my Russian translator today. She's indisposed. But yesterday we were talking about maintaining enthusiasm. So that's already there in Rupa Goswami's Nectar of Instruction, Utsahan Nishchayad Daryat. That first thing is Utsahan means enthusiasm. But often people get very enthusiastic about something, and for one reason, they lose interest. One of the main reasons is they have wrong expectations, or too big expectations, or they want things too fast. So, Utsahan Nishchayat means determination, stick with it. Don't give up, no matter what, no matter how it seems like nothing's coming from it. You know, seems like we're not making any advancement, even though, you know, we say we've been chanting for some time. But Krishna knows, and other people can notice. If we're very humble, of course, we'll think there's something wrong with me. Sometimes they think, well, there's something wrong with the process, so I'll give it up because it's not working. You know, I'm not becoming whatever I thought I would become in a quick enough time. Not able to give up all my bad habits and all these things. But Krishna stresses gradually, gradually, step by step, you know. So we're trying to do that. So then, Nishchayat, Dairyat. Dairyat means patience. And that's has to be there. That means tolerate, you know, don't think that, oh, it's not coming fast enough. I'm not getting what I want quick enough. I'm not getting what I expected. Because we have to know what to expect. And when we're preaching, we have to tell people also, if they're coming to Krishna consciousness, don't expect, you know, instant miracles, but it's a miracle if anybody takes it up and even reads the book. But if they take it up a little more and give up the sinful activities, then it's lots of miracles going on in the world like that. Many people make very quick advancement for different reasons. One is that, you know, from the previous life, and another is they're just very serious. They really have strong desire, because ultimately everything depends on desire. And others don't make so much advancement because maybe they're criticizing devotees, or they're not practicing, you know, focused chanting, they're not doing very much service, or they're doing the service for money or for fame and fortune. It doesn't work, and Krishna knows everything. So I was just reading Chaitanya Charitamrita. I'll just share a little bit. It's about different kinds of gurus. So Lord Chaitanya is saying that anyone who knows the science of Krishna can be a guru, no matter what his birth is, or, you know, it's all by qualification. So he can accept a spiritual master from any social status, provided a spiritual master is fully conversant with the science of Krishna. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur also states that although one is situated as a brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, shudra, brahmachari, vanaprastha, grihastha, if one is conversant with the science of Krishna, he can be a spiritual master as a Vartma Pradak But Vartma Pradarshika Guru, or a Diksha Guru, or a Shiksha Guru, spiritual master who first gives information about spiritual life, is called a Vartma Pradarshak Guru. Spiritual master who initiates according to the regulations of the Shastra is called a Diksha Guru. And the spiritual master who gives instructions for elevation is called a Shiksha Guru. Factually, the qualifications of a spiritual master depend on his knowledge of the science of Krishna. It is not matter whether he is a Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Sannyasi, or Sudra. This injunction is given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not at all against the injunctions of the Shastra. So, the book distributors are introducing so many people to Krishna, so they're you have many disciples, Vartma production of disciples. You won't remember them very much unless you meet some really spectacular person. But those people often knew something already. But if you somehow, you know, get people to accept the book and pray that they'll read it, you're their guru, you're that kind of guru. And if they ask a lot of questions, you know, if they're really serious, if they've known devotees before, then you can be Shiksha Guru. Not everybody wants to be Diksha Guru. Many of our acharyas, they didn't have any Diksha disciples, or only one or something like that. But they were giving so much instruction by writing books and, you know, teaching people. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati said, one-on-one preaching is better than preaching to a big crowd. So when you're, you know, out meeting people, it's all one-on-one, mostly. Sometimes there's two or three people, but mostly one person at a time, and they get very intimate association with the devotee. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastra Koi, all the scriptures declare Sadhu Sangha. And that's real Sadhu Sangha when you're just telling them about Krishna, telling them how great the book is. You know, that's telling them about Krishna. You don't have to say the name of Krishna. Just say how much we like the book and how it's, so many people have it. And then you're glorifying Krishna. So I'm just wanted to mention this Vartma Pradarshaka Guru. That's you know, it's a concept we don't think about so much, but Lord Chaitanya says, or Prabhupada's purport, very, very heavy, and he says, you know, doesn't matter what one's background is, and these three different kinds of gurus are equal spiritually, they're all working together. Somebody has to be introduced before they can meet a Shiksha Guru or a Diksha Guru. So the person who introduced him is, you know, a very important part of the chain. Is that kind of guru taught them the value of the book somehow or other, convinced people that the value of the book. So he quotes the Bhagavatam, yasya lalakshanam proktam pungso Varnab the Anjakam Yad Anyat Trapi Drishyeta Tat Tenaiva Vinishdeshit. If a person is born in a Sudra family but has all the qualities of a spiritual master, he should be accepted as not only as a Brahmin but as a qualified spiritual master. Also, this is also the instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So there's many different kinds of people, but so we want to be real Vaishnavas and we're Goshtananandis. We want to bring other people to the lotus feet of the Lord, the lotus feet of the spiritual master. But but you are also a spiritual master representing your spiritual master. Okay? Haribo. Thank you very much. Transcendental Book Distribution, Ki Jai. I'm hearing very ecstatic reports from Israel. I started out just doing this to send messages to the devotees in Israel, but, you know, because they speak Russian, but it's going out to probably many more people, so sometimes then I put it on my Facebook, and, you know, we're hoping that I'll get blessings for making this effort. I know Krishna will be pleased, but I don't know how effective it is, because I'm not very advanced myself, and I'm not going out, so I don't feel so, but I by doing this, I remember very ecstatic times I had on Sankirtan, and how many great realizations you get, you know, from meeting people like that. Okay? Thank you very much. Transcendental Book Distribution, Ki Jai. Srila Prabhupada's book, Ki Jai. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Ki Jai. Very important book for everybody to read. Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.